Hello everyone, I hope you are having a great day so far. You are going to learn 10 data structure concepts a Java developer should know. So why use data structure in programming? What is the purpose of using these concepts? You have used many applications which are super fast like Chrome browser or desktop application of Spotify. Why they are so fast and why they took a little time to perform action? The answer is simply data structures. The data structures maintain the time complexity and space complexity to ensure that your program is efficient in every way. So before starting, if you are new here, I am Asan and I post Java tutorials on this channel. If you might be interested in watching those videos, consider subscribing the channel. Let's start learning without wasted our time. The first concept of data structures is single linked list. Where do we use single linked list? This data structure can be used in music players for forwarding the song. If you want to go to the next song, the program will fetch the song on the next node of the single linked list and display you the song. The first node is the head and the last node is the tail. We always start inserting the data in the linked list through the first node, which is head, and so on. These nodes are linked with each other through a pointer. A pointer holds the next node of the current node. For example, this head's pointer holds the next node of the head, and so on. In this way, they are linked to each other and we can access them via a loop. Another concept of data structure is double linked list. Double linked list is same as the single linked list, but it has an extended functionality of coming back to the previous node. While in the single linked list, we can come back to the previous node. For example, in single linked list, if we are on this node, I can go back to the previous node. But double linked list provides this functionality, which helps us to retrieve the data of the previous node. Like single linked list, the concept of data structure is used in music players for forwarding and backward of the current song. Furthermore, we use this concept in browsers too. I can show you the example. For example, in Microsoft Edge, the web pages are stored in the nodes, and hence we can access previous and next web page through the backward and forward functionality. The next one is circular linked list. In this linked list, there is a loop from the tail to the head. In this way, it creates a loop. The last node is connected to the head node, which applies a property of looping. Like singular and double linked list, we can use this concept in music players. For example, if we reach to the end of our last song of our playlist, then we can access the first song by just going to the head node, which is the first node. Furthermore, this data concept is used in multiplayer games, which can create a loop between the players. So in that way, every player's turn comes after a loop. Next one is doubly circular linked list. The concept of data structure holds the concept of single, double, and circular. We can find every concept of linked list in this concept. It can create a loop, come back to the previous node, and go to the next node. Similarly, this concept is also used in music players, browsers for the same functionality used in single, double, and circular linked list. Furthermore, we can use this concept in undo and redo options in our clipboard, which temporarily holds the data which we copied. Another concept is this tags, which holds the property of last in, first out. The first node is called the top node, and the last node is called the bottom node. It has the same functionality as single linked list, but when we insert a node, it inserts the node at its head, and therefore when we delete a node, it deletes the node from its head, which satisfies the property of last in, first out. The common functions of the stacks are pop, peek, and insert. Pop is used for deleting a node from the linked list or stack and returns the top node's data. The peek function always return the top of the nodes. In this case, it returns 5. And the last is insertion function too, which is used to insert the node at the head. Stacks are usually used for conversion of infix to postfix notations, and we also use this concept in memory management of a system. Another concept is queue. Unlike the stack, it holds the property of first in, first out. Means the node which was inserted first will be dequeued first. It can also be implemented using the single linked list. The main function of the queues are front, which gives the nodes of the first node, the rear function, which gives the data of the last node, in queue function, which inserts the data to the queue, and the last is dequeue, which releases the data from the queue on the basis of first in, first out. This concept of data structures can be used in ticket system and in restaurants so that the first person ordering will get the order first. The seventh concept is priority queue, which works on the priority given to the node. If we give higher priority to the highest number, then it will dequeue first, and therefore the lower number is, the lower the priority it has. Like queue, it holds all the same functionality of enqueuing, dequeuing, and getting the element of the front and getting element of the rear. This concept is used in finding shortest path based on the priority given to the data. Also, it is used in Huffman coding techniques. And furthermore, we can use this concept in operating system to give priority to task system. Task has highest priority in this case. The next concept is hashing, which divides a big data into small chunks and is stored into the table. We can use this concept in encryption and decryption of data. It uses a formula, location is equals data to be inserted and the modulo size of the array. For example, if I want to insert 55, then 55 modulo 10, which is equals to 5. This answer 5 is the location of the data where it has to be inserted. In this case, it will insert at this location 5. Another concept of hashing is linear hashing. We use this concept for handling collisions. For example, if I inserted this data 55 and stored in the location 5 of this array, and again I wanted to insert 45, which results in 5, but now the location is occupied with the data 55. So in this case, we apply linear hashing for handling this type of collision. The formula is same, but we have to add the previous location, which is 5, to the value of the loop, which is I. In this case, then modulo 10, which is the size of the table. We must perform this action until we find an empty space. Furthermore, in hashing, we use minus 1, which represents an empty space so that the loop continues without any null pointer exception in the array. Last concept but not least is rehashing. It helps in insertion of data so that we have more places in the array if the value of the load factor increases. The implementation of this concept is same, but while inserting the element, it also checks the load factor. The default value of load factor is 0.75 and the formula is number of elements divided by array of size, which is 10 in this case. If this value increases, then we must increase the table size and insert the elements again. In this way, the array size increases, which helps us in the insertion of the data. I hope you had fun learning these concepts, which are very useful for a Java developer. If you like this video, then subscribe this channel and don't forget to click the bell icon to stay tuned. Thank you.